Hello everyone, my name is Rashid Khan from LPM Public School, Gola Bazar Gorakhpur, that is Lakshmi Prasad Memorial Public School, Gola Bazar Gorakhpur. And here we will have to discuss on the topic reproduction. So in that case, reproduction will have to go through the different types, importance, and its advantages and disadvantages. In this sequence, firstly we'll have to discuss on reproduction. So what is the reproduction called? So reproduction is the process by which any organism produce their young ones of their own kind. What is the reproduction? A reproduction is a process through which any organism can produce their young ones of their same kind. So it is the process through which any organism can produce their young ones of their same kind and same type. So what is the reproduction types? Here we will discuss on two types of reproduction. First one is asexual and second is sexual. So the sexual and asexual means of reproduction, there are the two types of reproduction you can see. What does it mean about asexual and sexual reproduction? Asexual reproduction is what? Asexual reproduction is a reproduction in which new organism produced by their single parents, or it is the process in which there is no parents, there is no two parents required to produce the young ones. That means there is no process takes place in which the male and female gamete fuse together. Only one type of a parent body can produce the young ones. So it is the type of a reproduction in which no need of the both parents, single parents can produce the young ones. There are the different type of asexual reproduction. What are these types? Asexual reproduction. Its type, what are these types? First one is vegetative reproduction. Second one is budding. Next one is fragmentation. Next one is spore formation. So these are all the kind of the asexual means of reproduction. So in which we will have to discuss on firstly the vegetative reproduction. So we will have to discuss on vegetative reproduction. It is also called as vegetative propagation. Why it is called as a vegetative propagation? Why? Because in case of a vegetative reproduction, the plants may grow, or plants may produce by the parts of a plants as well, from the roots, leaves, stem, and the different parts of the plant, a new plant can grow. that one is called as a vegetative reproduction. But actually no production takes place, no any new reproduction, no any new production takes place. Why? Because suppose if there is a sugar cane and from which the new plant growth, this new plant growth from this place and can see new plant from this particular part. So it is not the new one, it can be germinated or growth by the parent one. So this one is what? It is propagate. That means it proceeds. It only proceeds from a part of a plant to a new plant. The proceeding, that is the proceeding of propagation. It can only propagate, it can move forwarded or it can enhance, develop. So why this one is called as propagation? So it is also called as vegetative propagation. The vegetative reproduction also called as a vegetative propagation. In this concern, the vegetative propagation takes place by the means of leaves, stem, roots. That means the different parts of a plant, the different parts of a plant can grow a new plant through their stems, leaves, roots as well. So vegetative reproduction by the, firstly we discuss on vegetative reproduction takes place in case, first by the stem. So what are the different type of form of plant that can be grow, that can be germinated by means of the stems? So here we can say sugarcane, potatoes, onion, ginger, etc. These are all can germinated into new plants, grown into new plants by their stems. By the cutting their stems, when they placed inside the soil, it can be produced to the new plants. So these are all the plants will grow into the new ones, and this is the vegetative reproduction, form of a vegetative reproduction. It is a form of a vegetative reproduction. In that case, the reproduction, vegetative reproduction by the leaves, vegetative reproduction by the leaves, bryophyllum, and begonia. These two type of a plant
have leaf in which
these two type of plant have leaf
through which new plant can grow.
How it happens?
There is a plantlet's growth. Here is plantlet grow.
These plantlets,
these are the small plantlets that are growth on the margin of the leaf.
These plant grow on the margin of a leaf.
After being matured of the leaf, these plantlets falls down on the earth.
These plantlets falls down the earth and grow to the new plants. Having some certain period, this can be grow into the new plant.
These are called as bryophyllum and begonia.
So these are the two type of a plant that can grow on that level, that may be grow through their the parts of a plant as a leaf.
Next one,
next is
vegetative buds.
What are these buds are called? Some of the plant can grow into the new one by the formation of a buds or through the
buds. Buds ke through new plant grow kar sakte hain.
Kaun se wo plant hai? These plant may be known as
axillary bud. This is called as axillary buds.
Through the axillary buds, new plant can take place. A new plant produces. What are the example of these particular type of a vegetative production by the buds? This is called as
an axillary bud. From these axillary bud, the new plant can grow, and if the new plant grow, this will grow into the new developed form. So that particular axillary buds responsible for growing to the new one.
And the next one is
some of the plant
growth takes place by
the roots as well. Roots.
Some of the plants can vegetatively reproduce by the roots as well. Here we can see, what are these plant called? Like sweet potato, dahlia, sweet potato. Dahlia. Tamarind and Aspergillus. Aspergillus produced by their roots as well. These are all kind of the plants can be produced by the roots. Why? Because these having the roots like this. In case of Dahlia, you can see here, you can see the roots, root like structure in it. And through it, this can be developed into the new plant. Next one is some of the artificial criteria or method, artificial method by which the new plant grow, that is called as layering, cutting, grafting. Okay, we'll discuss on the next topic to the next video. You can see the next one, that is a vegetative reproduction by the artificial method. The artificial method of vegetative reproduction, you can say. In that case, there are the two important types. First one is layering. Second one is cutting, and third one is grafting, we can call it. These three types of artificial means of vegetative reproduction you can see. So we can say that these are the three methods by which artificial vegetative reproduction takes place. This is the artificial method. So in which, what will happen, I will discuss it. In case of layering, if the plants have, suppose there are a number of branches, of a plant, if the some branch are layered down towards the soil, some branch layers down towards the soil, and from the soil the new plant grows. The new plant take place, or the new plant growth from these particular parts. In case of jasmine, the plant grow and its lower branch falls are bent to the ground, and from this ground when it touches to the ground, so for a favorable condition, when there is a favorable conditions, these layering, the layer, these part of a branch which is tends to attach to the ground produces the new plant. So this one is said to be what? The layering. In case of cutting, most of the plants that can be cut it to its tip, and whenever the pasted by any tape or any clay or might be the some other dung material and bind very tightly, some of the time pass through the some days, there is a roots produces. So by the cutting it will be produced to the new plants as well. In case of a grafting, same kind of a plant when cut it, and then other plant of the same species can be adjusted to their bark or to their outer skin. When these new plants grow, they these are called as a, the upper part is called as a scion, and the next, that is the lower part, is termed as stalk. Stalk, and the under the soil, that one is called as a stalk, and upper part is called as a scion, through which this can be grow into the new plant, that one is called as a grafting. Okay, we'll discuss on later onto this topic into the next.